Hello and welcome. Thank you for tuning in. My name is Omar Santos. I am very excited to have Chloe here with me to talk about our next virtual event, the Hacking is Not a Crime HackerCon. So we have an amazing lineup of speakers, and we wanted to actually give you a summary of all the different activities that are actually happening during this virtual event. However, before we go actually into the presentation details, Chloe, if you don't mind, can you give me a 2-minute overview of what is Hacking is Not a Crime and how is it so relevant nowadays?
Yeah, first of all, thanks for having me. Second is Hacking is Not a Crime is like your go-to shop or your site for anyone in the hacker community or people that want to know about the hacker community and also to know where are the resources at. I think the one thing is entering this space in the hacker community, we don't really know who to go to for things. And also like resources, where are some resources? Because at this time, I hate to break it to people, but hackers don't have rights. And that's why it's so important to start pushing this messaging out is that hacking is not a crime. It's what you do. It's the intent at the end of the day. If your intent is malicious, then yes, that is a crime. But the reality, hackers are not criminals. Attackers are the criminals. And so that's what Hacking is Not a Crime is all about, is to bring public perception to the forefront and for the public to be more understandable about who we are as hackers and change that public perceptions and question those socially constructed beliefs. And we do have a good number of advocates that are also pushing this out by talking to the press, reminding the press that, you know, hackers are different from attackers and to use the correct terminology, use the right imagery for that. And then we also work with legislators to get them informed about the hacker community and why they shouldn't be scared of us. Instead, they should be working with us. And then also besides those is working with organizations that want to practice vulnerability disclosure policies and for them to get the courage sometimes is needed to get vulnerability disclosure policies up there, but also for them to be more aware of the hacker community and how we're not your enemies, we are your friends that's trying to protect and serve you. And it's not about payments, it's about protecting people at the end of the day.
Absolutely. And one of the things that I want to highlight is the amazing community that you have already engaged in here, a whole bunch of advocates. And again, this is actually just one out of the many different presentations that you actually have done, others in the community have done, and really, really excited about this one. So for this one, it's on March 27th. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to share the schedule. And Chloe, if you don't mind highlighting, I guess, you know, from a high level, what are the things happening during that conference?
Right. So I think the one thing was that right when we kicked off Hacking is Not a Crime, we immediately saw that there was a need for people to be more aware of where we stand as a community when it comes to legislation, when it comes to talking to the press, when it comes to vulnerability disclosure, but also who are the organizations that are protecting us and fighting for us. And so that's how this came about, was HackerCon came together to bring all these elements into one. So we have talks on upcoming legislation that you need to be aware of. Also current and past legislation that you probably should know of at this point. That means the CFA is going to be definitely discussed. We're also going to have talks on how to do better disclosure. So if you're an organization that's thinking about having vulnerability disclosure policies or you already have them, this would be a great day for you to attend. So then you can learn a little bit more how to do better on that front, but also for the hacker community to learn how to do disclosure better. So you're not ignored and you don't have to worry too much about the lawsuit front, because the thing is like, you should not feel alone right now. We exist to be there and support you. And also the organizations that support hacker rights, we have the EFF showing up. We have I'm the Calvary, disclose.io, Hacking is Not a Crime, of course. Those are some of the organizations that are coming. We also have talks on how to talk to the press. I know one of the things in the hacker community is always about like, I just found this vulnerability, I'm going to go contact the press. But we need to learn how to be better with the press, because the press, they can be our friends if they learn more about us and if we have better communication with them. And that's one of the things that we need to improve on as a community. And so you'll also see talks about that, how to be better with the press, how to work with the press as well.
Awesome. And a few things that I want to highlight, and I'm going to be sharing the links in the bottom of the screen. One is the website of Hacking is Not a Crime, just hackingisnotacrime.org. And of course, you're familiar with the Red Team Village website, that hopefully you're tuning in through it, and our Discord server. By the way, this event will be streamed live through Twitch, YouTube, and of course, the conversation will be in Discord. All those links I have it in the bottom of this video and in the description as well. Thank you, Chloe. I really appreciate your time today. Looking forward to seeing you, everybody, and have a good day.